You defeating Kansas on January 10th in East Lansing. Michigan State 37.
Boards. The last time these two teams met, January 10th, Kansas was out rebounded by 11, which made all the difference in the world in that game.
That's right. The last time these two teams met each other, 75-62, MSU defeating Kansas on January 10th in East Lansing. Michigan State 37-18 at halftime. Lucas had 22 in the first half. That ball knocked out of bounds. And as we talked yesterday, as we watched practices for Kansas, they need a better effort from Morningstar and Reed.
Yeah, I mean, it really comes down to they've got to have a more balanced attack. This is a different brand of defense that they're facing right here with Michigan State, among the leaders, certainly in the Big Ten in the defensive categories, and they led the nation in rebound margin with almost 10 by almost plus 10 per game.
Morningstar and Reed a combined 4 of 17 in the first two rounds. Collins driving, kicks, first shot up. That one off the mark for Morningstar. Rebounded by Sutton, outlet taken away by Taylor. Baseline, Collins wide open. Around the rim, no. Delvon Rowe with the rebound. And here come the Spartans.
Both teams, good man-to-man teams, and that's their primary defense. Cole Aldridge again, he's going to test whoever he's guarding right now. Delvon Rowe is going to test him whether he can make some shots. Otherwise, he's going to play that one-man zone in the paint.
There's Brady Morningstar on the season, averaging 7 points per game. Great three-point shooter, 50 of 117 coming into this one. That's 43%. And he's going to get open looks because Collins can break down the defense. Morgan. Lucas straightaway three. Ball batted around, Aldridge with the rebound. Outlet Collins. Lucas is back. Takes him one-on-one. Lost his footing and turns it over. Good defense by Kalen Lucas. And Len, what are the keys?
Well, you mentioned it for Kansas, a little help from their friends, more offensive from the support players versus an outstanding Michigan State defense. And for Michigan State, you got to put a suit on Cole Aldridge, fresh off his triple-double. You know Goran Sutton, the best post defender for Michigan State, is going to play him, but expect an awful lot of big guys from Michigan State to have their opportunity.
Morgan inside, gives up his dribble and travels.
Well, that's two times right now that we've seen outstanding defenses. On the one end, Sharon Collins, there was good anticipation, took his move away. And here, Cole Aldridge presents a challenge for Raymar Morgan and forces the turnover.
So here comes Collins. He had 32 and 8 against North Dakota State. 25 against Dayton. And there he is, knocking down a jump shot from the baseline. Lucas the other way. Aldridge blocks it out of bounds.
On that last Kansas possession, Sharon Collins just shows you how unconscious he is in the last two games leading to this one, averaging 28 points and 5 assists.
In their first meeting, Collins ended with 25, but he had 5 points and 6 turnovers in the first half. And MSU, as you mentioned, did a great job on the boards out-rebounding him, 42 to 31.
Well, that's Michigan State's eraser right there. Pound the boards, get second chance opportunities, increase possessions.
Pick and roll, Lucas. Sutton can pop out and hit a jump shot. Inside, Aldridge takes it away. Outlet pass in the front court. Morris bangs it down.
Outstanding post defense by Cole Aldridge, moving his feet, getting those long arms in the passing lane, and then a picture perfect outlet pass.
Marcus Morris. His twin brother, Markeith, on the bench. They're out of Philadelphia. Morgan jump shot rims off. Rebounded by Tyshawn Taylor. Good transition defense that time by the Spartans to get back. As you know, Kansas wants to push it. Inside Aldridge, up short, batted around, no. Sutton claims it. Here comes Lucas, galloping into the front court. Walton had 18 against USC. Jump shot really going down for him. Now Delvon Rowe looks weak side. Sutton back door.
Oh, that's a nice look right there. Catching the cutters down the lane as Kansas fell asleep.
Sutton had 7 points against SC. Played some good defense, though, on Taj Gibson, their best front court player. Morris facing now. Very skilled. Zuton with another rebound.
And Gus, you see right now, Kansas, the support guys are being very aggressive offensively.
Morgan rims off. Zuton with a rebound. Walton, 15-footer. And here comes Collins. Great pace to start. Collins, hard Chicago in and out. And he's fouled.
Well, we talked about Goran Suton, the best post defender for Michigan State, has a battle on his hands with Cole Aldridge. And look at him try to front. The key to success, and that time, Suton not successful in stopping the pass, but Aldridge misses the layup. The key to success in guarding Cole Aldridge, if Suton's going to front, you got to have maximum ball pressure so the passer can't hit that kind of pinpoint lob.
Well, what's the difference, Len, between fronting him and playing behind him?
Well, you play behind him, particularly if he's close to the basket, his reach is beyond the reach of Goran Suton to get yourself in trouble. You got to front, you got to deny him the pass, but you need help with ball pressure on the pass.
Jump shot off the mark for Suton. Here come the Jayhawks. Taylor, the very impressive freshman out of Hoboken, New Jersey, played at St. Anthony's for Coach Hurley, won the national championship. Aldridge almost lost it, and a whistle and foul. And this will go against Michigan State's green. 15:38 to play in the first half. Kansas up 5-2. A look at threes versus twos in the regional semifinals.
And as the Rock and Roll Classic says, two out of three ain't bad. You take a look, Villanova, Missouri over the number two seeds, and Oklahoma, a number two seed, obviously playing as sharp as anybody in this tournament, defeats Syracuse.
Tom Izzo's Michigan State Spartans a two, Kansas the defending national champs three. Don't forget, coming up, it's a one versus a four as the Zags take on Tyler Hansbrough and the North Carolina Tar Heels. That game will tip at 10. Aldridge, free throw line. First one going down. Cole Aldridge, 13 points, 20 rebounds, 10 block shots against Dayton. Triple-double. First block shot triple-double since 92 when Shaq did it in Boise.
And how about this for a line for two NCAA tournament games? 18 points, 16 rebounds, and 6 blocks is what Aldridge is averaging over the first two.
Very good free throw shooter at 79% on the season. Collins almost stole it. Kalen Lucas. Allen has checked in. He can extend the defense along with Summers. Both of them athletic three-point shooters. Lucas splitting the defense. Knocked around, picked up Aldridge. Long outlet pass, Collins. Cherry picking in the front court. Gets to the bucket, reverse layup, got it.
Little change of speed, maybe created by the fumble. But that was enough to get Sharon Collins an open layup.
So Sharon Collins off to a good start with 5 points. Here's Summers.
You know, it's the rebounding of Cole Aldridge and the outlet passes that have created some easy opportunities for Kansas. Michigan State not able to keep the ball alive as often as they would like early here in this game.
Summers has 3 rebounds. Michigan 8, 1-for-8 to start the game. Shot clock winding down. Lucas has to hurry. He's got Aldridge on him. Takes him off the dribble. Up and in. He kept it close until the final moment.
Little man making a big man chase.
Collins stripped. Here comes Lucas. Kicks it out. Allen will shoot that one. And hit.
That's outstanding play by Kalen Lucas. He knew who the shooter was. And he knew exactly where to deliver the ball.
Spartans right back in this game now. 9-7. Aldridge calling for it inside. Morningstar, one dribble. And he babied it. Morris saves it from going out of bounds. Outlet, Lucas. He's got Green. Weak side, Summers rising fire. Got it.
Well, after a little early game jitters, Michigan State starting to operate on all cylinders. And you see Kansas recognizing they need more from their support players. Those guys have been aggressive to the basket, aggressive looking for their shots, but Brady Morningstar cannot feel the pressure. He's got to let it loose.
Spartans on an 8-0 run. Morris deep. He fires a brick. Morningstar there, though, for the stick back. Right place, right time. Michigan State coming the other way, 4 of 11, 36%. Here's Lucas. Nice look. Sutton. Green there. No. And he can't get the second one to go either. Here comes Collins, head of steam. Morris wants it on the box. Inside, Aldridge, and he's fouled.
Well, Michigan State only down one, and it was all Kalen Lucas, Big Ten Player of the Year. That time, little okey-doke with Cole Aldridge, and here finding the shooter. Chris Allen running to his left. And one more time, Kalen Lucas, the trigger man, as Darrell Summers knocks down a three. And Kalen Lucas knows where everybody is on the floor, gets him set up nicely, a little penetration, makes sure the guys get it where they can use it.
And Aldridge getting the first one to go. Check out the plays we're considering for Pontiac game-changing performance of the tournament. And while there, enter each week for a chance to win a trip for four to this year's Final Four only at Pontiac.com/NCAA.
I was going to say, on that last series of replays, a great example of what Kalen Lucas, despite just being 6 feet, the impact he can have on a game, particularly bringing his team back.
And a sub coming in now for the Jayhawks, Mario Little, as Aldridge heads to the bench. Also, Tyrell Reed, number 14, in for Kansas.
And for Michigan State, Edong Ebok in the game. Bill Self doesn't want Cole Aldridge to have to play against the substitute big men for Michigan State. Doesn't want to wear him down. In the first game, Ebok did a pretty decent job against Aldridge while in the ball game.
Also, Corey Lucius, very impressive freshman from Milwaukee, throws it away. Morningstar.
That's letting it hang out. We said Brady Morningstar can't be shy.
And the Jayhawks go up by five. Walton has been quiet, guarded by Reed, runs a pick and roll with Ebok, takes the jump shot, batted around, Summers going up, and a whistle and foul. This will be over the back coming up against State.
But if you're Tom Izzo, you're not displeased with that. You may be displeased with the call, but the effort going to the offensive glass, that's what this team needs to do. That's their modus operandi. 9.9 plus 9.9 to lead the nation in rebounding. You got to go to your strength.
Taylor, and now an offensive foul. Looks like a moving screen, and will go against Marcus Morris. 11:58 to play in the first half. Kansas with a 5-point lead. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the tournament summary.
Well, the Big East setting a standard all season. And you look at the Big 12 teams, Oklahoma, you had to know that they have potential. But how about Missouri? That's a surprise, beating Memphis and then hanging 100 on one of the best defensive teams all year. And Pittsburgh reaching the Elite Eight for the first time since 1974, a team that's had the potential to do it, maybe didn't have the scores necessary. But as close as the game was against Xavier, they're starting to put it all together.
15-10, Kansas on top of Michigan State. Kansas on a mini 6-0 run,
nice,
in response to Michigan State's earlier 8-0 spurt. And a foul inside should send the Spartans to the line.
And we've seen Michigan State go to several guys in their last several possessions. You know, several different guys have been able to touch the ball. That time, Raymar Morgan on a nice back door. And we talked about Kalen Lucas. But also, we got Corey Lucius as well as Travis Walton, guys capable of distributing and making sure everybody gets a touch.
Don't forget Gonzaga, North Carolina coming up next. Tip at 10 o'clock. Michigan State is 20-2 when Raymar Morgan plays 20 minutes or more. He has been plagued by illness this year. As we see subs come in the game, Morningstar heads to the bench. Sharon Collins back in the game. Raymar Morgan has been plagued with some walking pneumonia, which forced him to miss three games. That turned into mononucleosis. played limited minutes in six other games. Collins guarded by Walton.
Good defense right there. Morgan doesn't allow Collins to split the double team and forces a turnover.
Walton, Summers. Lucius, he is not afraid to go to the basket, and he draws a foul.
Well, Gus, you talked about Raymar Morgan, and before the illness, which occurred in mid-January up until about mid-February, he's having a pretty good season, averaging 15 points a game, shooting 60% from the field. But since then, only averaging 6 points a game and shooting way below that 60% number. Still feeling some of the effects, looking for that same rhythm, that same comfort that he had prior to getting sick.
Lucius Morgan, Allen around a screen, fired. And the rebound goes to the big man, Aldridge. Morris picks it up off the floor and a foul.
Well, you see Michigan State in their backcourt. They're doing their best to try to deny Sherron Collins the ball once he gives it up. Travis Walton, the best defensive player in the Big Ten, defensive player of the year, three-time all-defensive team, is given that job. And when the screens come, you look at Walton jumping on top, not allowing Collins to go behind on top of the screen to get it, and forcing him to go behind, which leads him into help.
Draymond Green back in, along with Kalen Lucas. Winner will take on Louisville in the regional final. Taylor driving to the basket. Nice dish. Aldridge stripped though. Draymond Green got it out of his hands. The freshman, and Aldridge knocks it out of bounds.
Well, Aldridge kind of looks down at his hand, thought he might have been fouled. That looked like pretty good hands right there. Draymond Green gets a little piece of the ball. Aldridge didn't hold on to it. You got to be strong with it when you're inside like that.
Five turnovers for Kansas. Inside, Sutton somehow slips to the basket wide open. And Walton put it on him. 1 point game. Inside Aldridge, nice catch. Goes up, no. And a whistle, and this foul will go against the Jayhawks. And the foul is called on Marcus Morris as he picks up his second. In the game now, Markeith Morris, his twin brother, who wears number 21. Sutton. Lucas. And that ball kicked and out of bounds. Watch live look-ins, in-game highlights, and more all night on March on NCAA March Madness Central, powered by Pontiac. Tomorrow at 4:30, only on the CBS College Sports Network.
And you take a look at Michigan State's offensive attack. They're not messing around. Knowing that the wings are getting denied by Kansas, they're immediately going backdoor. They've had a chance to get a couple of those, but they're using the aggressive Kansas defense against them. Use aggression by going backdoor.
Skip past Sutton, goes up high for it, and he traveled.
A little hesitation right there on that back foot. Sutton didn't know whether to raise up for the jumper or put it on the floor.
Five turnovers for Tom Izzo's team.
And he who hesitates turns it over.
Inside, Morris. They find Aldridge. Aldridge again. Too strong. Picked up Walton. Allen is on his wing.
If there's any place that Michigan State wants Cole Aldridge to shoot the ball, that's where it is, 10 foot and beyond.
Sutton pops out, baseline jump shot, got it. Nice play, Lucas and Sutton thinking with the same brain. And the Spartans take a 1 point lead. Michigan State on a 6-0 run.
And the more Sutton can pull Cole Aldridge outside, the easier it is for the Michigan State guards to penetrate.
Collins step back jump shot.
Step back, fall back, baby. Hit the ground after that one.
Lucas wraps it around, knocked away, picked up. Aldridge, lead pass, Taylor. Watch out, bam! I tell you what, Kansas is getting up and getting down. Cole Aldridge is outletting the ball like Wes Unseld.
Well, fundamentally sound with both hands, a two-hand outlet pass after you get the rebound. And his guys are streaking down the sidelines, just waiting for it.
2016, Jayhawks. Lucas.
That was a double dribble or a travel, either one.
And he's saying that the ball was hit, but the officials aren't going for it. Kalen Lucas, Big Ten Player of the Year, only a sophomore from Sterling Heights, Michigan.
And number 15, Darrell Summers.
Tom Izzo will have a conversation with his leader. A lot of rumors swirling around Arizona looking for a head coach. Tom Izzo's name has been mentioned as a possible successor to Lute Olson. Rumor has it that sometimes he doesn't feel as appreciated in East Lansing as he should be. 20-16. Pops out, Collins puts it on the deck, and a reach-in foul. And some jawing going on between the Spartans and the Jayhawks. Back after this.
Greg Gumbel in New York with an update from Memphis. North Carolina running the floor early in the early moments of this game. This is Deion Thompson on the scoring end of the dunk. Carolina with a 9-4 lead. Under 17 and a half to play in the first. Gus and Len, back to you.
All right, Greg, thank you very much. The winner of that game will take on Oklahoma as the Sooners defeated Syracuse earlier this evening. Our score right here, 20-16, Kansas. Under 8 minutes to play, first half. The winner of this game takes on Louisville, who destroyed Arizona. Taylor pick and roll, curls to the basket, the runner no, and an offensive foul coming up. Nicely done. Green slides in, takes the charge, and Taylor picks up his first.
Well, you mentioned it, Gus. Wes Unseld perfected it, and the rest of us copied. That's old school right there, the two-hand outlet pass. What it does, it allows you to pull it back in case the defender steps in. You got plenty of control, and certainly you can get accuracy and distance from it. You know, I learned to do that. Bill Walton, a bunch of other centers during the 70s, was glad to see the oldies but goodies return.
And now another foul, and it will go against Michigan State. As Ebach got caught setting a screen and grabbing. And that is the eighth turnover for Michigan State. Kansas has turned it over six times. So here come the Jayhawks, 7 of 18 from the field. 39% shooting. Collins has been quiet offensively lately. Tyrell Reed, Morningstar, Morris drops down off the glass, nice.
And you see Kansas making a concerted effort to call plays and get other guys involved. That wasn't just Sharon Collins or Cole Aldridge. They gave Morningstar, they gave Morris opportunities.
Allen all the way around the corner, fifth rebound, Aldridge, baseline Reed. Lucius gets back. And now the Jayhawks will run their offense. Collins looking.
And I think what gives Bill Self comfort in calling plays for other guys is their willingness to go to the basket, their willingness to look at the basket, as opposed to the first two games when it was just Collins and Aldridge for the most part.
Morningstar wraps it around. Ebach with the block, gets up again. No. Dan, it's tapped up by an end by Aldridge. Aldridge now with 6-9-0 run for the Jayhawks. Lucius shuffles it over to Allen.
And his legs taken out from by Reed, but no call. Good no call by the official.
Lucius picks up his dribble and a steal. Second time he's thrown the ball away. Morningstar. And they got to get the freshman out of the game. 26-16, Kansas. 11-0 run.
If you need to find a cab in a strange city, there's an app for that. or figure out your share of the bill for a table of five. There's an app for that. Or fix a wobbly bookshelf. There's even an app for that. Yep, there's an app for just about anything, only on the iPhone.
Watch exclusive video of Amen Corner, plus 15 and 16 live, and bonus coverage of the entire field with Masters Extra at cbssports.com/masters live and masters.com. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore with you. 26-16, Kansas with the lead. Michigan State brings Lucas, Morgan, Sutton, Walton, and Rowe back in the game. Baseline. Morgan short-armed it. Long rebound picked up by Lucas. Now Sutton wide open. Rims off. Morgan with the rebound. Walton somehow picks it up. Michigan State doing a nice job offensive rebounding. And the Spartans get a new shot clock.
And that's their version of the eraser. Go back and get it. Try it again.
Aldridge is not on the floor for Kansas. He's taking a blow. Inside, Rowe. Back to Sutton. And one.
Excellent movement without the ball on the part of Goran Sutton. Nice little give and go. And as soon as the ball goes in the row, Kansas defense, their focus turns to the man with the ball, and Sutton gets himself in excellent position right in front of the 10. You see him? Collins had him, turned his head. And when a defender turns his head, that's when you lose your man.
Sutton adds the free throw. Just like that, Michigan State clawing their way back, 26-19. Bill Self has a decision. When does he put Aldridge back in the game? Trying to let him get some air on the bench right now. Without that shot blocker in, this Kansas team totally different.
Well, they certainly have to focus more on defense, particularly out on the perimeter, not allowing their men to get free in the paint.
Little, jump stop inside. Gets it back to Collins with 10 to shoot. Wants to shake up Walton. He'll fire. Spinning. Double. Reversal. Reed deep. And the rebound. Little stick back. Good hustle by the Jayhawks.
Amari Little has the ability to be that reliable third scorer that Kansas needs. 7 points against Dayton. 3 of 4.
Morgan down the lane, and he turns it over. Collins leans in and banks it down. I tell you what, this young man, Sherron Collins, is a super athlete. McDonald's All-America. Played big minutes last year. As a matter of fact, he had the assist on the Mario Chalmers three that tied it with 2.1 to go to send it in the overtime in the national championship game.
And Kansas has gone to zone right now, really establishing themselves. I guess without Cole Aldridge in the middle, they want to keep people out of the middle.
Now Aldridge will come back into the game. They're playing for this. Some serious hardware. The national championship trophy.
Vitamin Water presents a Revive to Survive comeback moment. In 1990, Scott Burrell's full court pass hits Tate George, who spins and hits the game winner as top-seeded UConn beats Clemson to advance to the Elite Eight. The buzzer beater is forever known in the UConn annals as simply the shot. Bounce back from NCAA March Madness with Vitamin Water Revive, official hydration partner of NCAA championships.
Greg Hummel in New York, in Memphis in the early going. It's North Carolina. Ty Lawson with 8 points, including the bucket on this drive here. It's 23-16. Tar Heels, 11:40 to play in the first half. Gus and Lenny, back to you.
All right, Greg, the winner of that game goes on to take on Oklahoma. And a look at the game summary.
Well, Michigan State really hurt by the turnovers. 10 turnovers, but you look at Kansas, shooting the ball well from the field. Aldridge Collins, 16 points, but the support players, the help from their friends that they needed, 14 points among the guys who surround Collins and Aldridge, and that's a recipe for success for Kansas.
Kansas is on a 15-3 run to take its largest lead of the game. 30-19. Now Michigan State inside. They allow Aldridge to catch it. Reverse layup, no. Loose ball. Aldridge is there for the power jam.
We'll give Markieff Morris a lot of credit for keeping it alive, giving Aldridge that second opportunity. And again, Kansas right now winning the battle of the boards against Michigan State.
17-14. Kansas out rebounding the Spartans.
And remember, Michigan State, number one rebounding team in the country.
And the first time they faced each other on January 10th, Michigan State out rebounding the Jayhawks 42-31. Different story tonight so far. Baseline row. Sutom bumped from behind and he's fouled. Coming up on AT&T at the half, Greg Gumbel, Greg Anthony, and Seth Davis will take you out for a live look at the Gonzaga North Carolina game, and they will get you caught up on all of the latest tournament news, plus an AT&T Naismith watch update. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Foul called on Markieff Morris, and that is his first. Kansas with 17 fouls, so Sutton shooting 1-1, 2:48 to play. Each team with 17 fouls.
We take a look at the stars. Sharon Collins, Cole Aldridge kind of expected that, but they're certainly getting help from their teammates. And Goran Sutton having a nice job, doing a nice job from the field. And Kalen Lucas really can't get on track right now offensively, even though he's done a nice job in distributing the ball with three assists.
32-21. Here comes Collins walking it up the floor. Collins will get it back with 15 to shoot. Looking inside for Aldridge. Now Sutton playing behind him. Collins driving. Taylor strip. Kalen Lucas with the steal. Lucas straight to the basket. Up and in. And a timeout called by the Jayhawks. 2:12 to play. First half, 32-23. Back after this.
Liability, bad. Drinkability, good. Not too heavy, not too light. Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
Want to get away? Now you can with Southwest Hot Fare Sale. From $49 to $99 one way with no hidden fees. Only at Southwest.com. Low fares, no hidden fees.
Let's take a look at some shining moments.
Well, Earl Clark, part of an outstanding win by Louisville, dominating win. Chase Bunniger on the wrong side of that, but still nevertheless showed up. And Blake Griffin, again, being Blake Griffin against a tough Syracuse team. And I can just see, even though we were doing a simultaneous game, I could see Griffin getting in the middle of that zone, hitting the mid-range, running out on the break, just doing everything that he's capable of doing.
What a player. Inside, another turnover for the Jayhawks. Summers leaves it. Lucas to the hole. He missed the jam. He tried to flush it over two Jayhawks. Morris and Reed stretched out on the floor.
And in a bit of a late call, and you see right here the steal and the push. Officials call a block. I'm not sure Reed was essentially in legal guarding position. Didn't have both feet down where he had to be stationary before Lucas took off.
Lucas only 6 feet as he hits the first. Kid has an unbelievable will, an iron will.
Well, you don't become player of the year in a tough conference like the Big Ten at 6 feet tall without having that and then some.
32-25. 6 points now for Lucas as the Michigan State faithful rise. They're on a 6-0 run. Inside, knocked away Sutton.
Much better defense, ball pressure. Collins couldn't hit the target.
Back-to-back-to-back turnovers for Kansas. Here's Allen for three. Sutton bats it back to Allen. and they knock it off Aldridge. It'll hold on.
Michigan State now playing their game on the defensive end. Sutton playing behind Aldridge until Aldridge tries to get set, and then he whips in front right here. And then the ball pressure, you see Kalen Lucas getting a hand in the face of the passer who couldn't hit the target, and Sutton with the interception.
New shot clock for the Spartans.
And then on the other end, obviously, second chance opportunity for Michigan State, rebounding.
Teardrop inside Lucas, rims off. Aldridge snatches it. They find Collins at the midcourt line. 8 rebounds for Aldridge, and Collins knocks down a jump shot in transition. Sweet player.
Just froze him and then elevated.
Allen spinning. Green. His first basket of the game, 34-27.
Draymond Green putting together a nice little tournament here. In the first two games, 8 of 10 from the field. Had a career-high 16 points in 17 minutes against Robert Morris. He's given Michigan State some valuable minutes.
Aldridge facing. Reed, the kick, Morningstar. Some timely baskets from him. They're going to try to find Collins as the shot clock winds down.
And look at Lucas trying to deny. Too late.
Sharon spinning. No. Aldridge picks it up. What? You're kidding. A 20-foot jump shot for Aldridge, and he has 10. 36-27, Kansas.
You get the feeling this is his tournament, right?
No doubt about it. 4 seconds to go. Lucas drives, kicks. Sutton. Count it. No, they wave it off. But one official is saying he feels that it's good. So they'll have to go to the replay.
As they should. Gonna take a look right here. On the penetration, the kick. Clock.
Ooh.
It looked like it left his hands. Once more. Out. Whoa, it was almost simultaneous.
Oh,
that's almost simultaneous. It looked like we see the light go on, but obviously it's clock light. But that's
something.
So close to call.
Here's another look.
I don't know, even by that split second, just by the naked eye with the replay and slow motion, still seem that the fraction, they got it out of his hands. I hope he manicured his fingernails.
Yes.
Now that pulling it back. See, right there, it looked like it was out.
I don't think he did manage
by his fingernail.
Wow. Let's see. Here's the decision coming up. And they're going to count it. They will count the basket. So the end of the first half, 36-29, Kansas. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel in New York with AT&T at the half after this message and a word from your local station. You're watching the men's NCAA basketball championship exclusively on CBS.
State Farm, Burger King, and by Chevy.
Halftime in Indy, Kansas with a 36-29 lead. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore, Kansas playing a very efficient first half, and they're also winning the battle of the boards.
Well, they certainly are winning the battle in the paint, 22-10 over Michigan State, and they're winning the battle of the boards. Michigan State, the top rebounding team in the country. But Michigan State has also turned the ball over 10 times, giving Kansas some points. They've got to get higher percentage shots because Kansas is doing it in the lane.
All right, let's take a look at the CBS Fox Score, powered by CBS College Sports Network, cable's home for NCAA March Madness.
Well, you see, Goran Sutton, he's getting the job done, doing a pretty good defensive job on Cole Aldrich, who's efficient but not dominating. But it still comes down to Michigan State's offense. They got to get better shots. They got to get in the paint and get high percentage shots. Take a look at Cole Aldrich. We talked about him being effective but not dominating. Nevertheless, still blocking shots. Aldrich with two blocks so far. And Sherron Collins doing what we've come to expect of him in the NCAA tournament. 5 of 6 on the field, 12 points. He does have 4 turnovers. But Kansas is getting what we talked about that they needed. Other guys are getting involved in the offense. And while it may not be a lot beyond Brady Morningstar's 6 points, still guys are becoming threats. And that's what they need so that defenses can't load up on Aldridge and Collins.
So here we go, ready for the second half. As Michigan State sends out Lucas, Summers, Morgan, Walton, and Sutton.
You know, Gus, Michigan State shooting 36%, 10 of 28. A lot of perimeter stuff. Very little in the paint. Certainly a lot has to do with Cole Aldridge's presence. But they've got to find a way to get higher percentage shots.
Sutton backs his way in, finds Morgan. Morgan has his shot blocked by Aldridge.
I guess it's easier said than done. Hitting to the paint with Aldridge standing there, manning the middle.
Third block by Aldridge in this game. Taylor, Aldridge, Collins, Morris, Morningstar for the Jayhawks. Morningstar not ready for that pass.
You're a shooter. How can you not be ready?
And the ball poked out of Aldridge's hands and out of bounds. Right to us.
Again, when you challenge a shot blocker, you got to go right at him. Raymar Morgan kind of fades away, and that gives room for Aldridge to reach and get it. Go straight up. Make contact. Don't shy away from it. I think Raymar Morgan just needs a mean streak with all that talent. He just doesn't go to the basket with the aggression that he should.
Pick and roll. Lucas, he's aggressive. Fires. In and out. Aldridge clears it. And here come the Jayhawks. Collins. First half had 12 points on 5 of 6 shooting. Pulls up and hits.
Does he ever miss?
I don't think he does.
I mean, he is on the money.
He is a wonderful athlete. Was a great football player and baseball player in high school. Walton has been quiet offensively after that 18-point game against USC. Baseline, Sutton hits.
Oh, that's a nice pass and pop. But Goran Sutton had a chance to take Aldridge in the paint, thought better of it, kicked it, and stepped back outside.
Aldridge again, stripped, turns it over again.
That's not his game, turning and facing, putting it on the floor. Got to play with your teammate.
Summers, deep jumper. Got it. Michigan State can score points in bunches. Spartans have trailed by as many as 13. 38-34 now. And knocked out of bounds. The winner of this game will take on the Louisville Cardinals, who defeated Arizona. And tomorrow, Connecticut, Missouri. How do you see that game breaking down?
Well, first of all, Connecticut, we're talking about Cole Aldridge's ability to block shots and close the middle. Ashim Thabeet, probably the best in the country. But it's going to be about handling the pressure. And Missouri applies it.
Morningstar driving, lobs it inside, rebounded Morris, power dribble, and a whistle.
Kansas really battling Michigan State to advantage on the glass.
Got to tell you, Lynn, I like the way the officials have called this tournament. There have been some bad calls, but I think overall the officials have done a great job of allowing players to play. They've managed the game, and we haven't seen a bunch of ticky-tack fouls. Therefore, play has been a lot more fluid than in the past.
Yeah, and all the player asks for is establish the game early, let us know what you expect, and then allow the players to go out and play, particularly with officials who haven't really officiated games between the two teams. I mean, you got officials from different conferences, haven't seen these guys. So that's the best course of action. Let the players play.
And Marcus Morris makes it a 40-34 game. Lucas Green leans in and banks it home. This kid has some talent, only a freshman.
Well, we talked about the solid contribution now here in his third game in the NCAA tournament.
Collins floating, finally missed one. Here come the Spartans running now. Walton high-stepping, slashing. Green can't hold on. Walton gets it again, and this time Green lays it up and one. 17:02 to play second half. Things are getting hot in Indy. 40-38, Kansas holding on to the lead, but here comes State.
Michigan State making a push to come even with Kansas, and sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. You see Draymond Green fumble the pass, Walton gets it back, and Green goes up strong and is fouled. And we talk about the contribution Draymond Green has made. He's been absolutely outstanding. We talked about Robert Morris, 16 points in 17 minutes, 9 rebounds against Southern Cal. He's come in and he's really made his presence felt.
Michigan State with that free throw on a 10-4 run here in the second half to cut the Kansas lead to 1. Morningstar, baseline Morris, and a whistle. And this will go against the Spartans inside as Aldridge attacked the basket. And that foul is called on Sutton, and he picks up his second foul. Two team fouls against Michigan State. Taylor driving. Morningstar poked away from behind. Great hands by Kalen Lucas. Michigan State with an opportunity to take the lead on this trip.
And for Kansas, it's almost like deja vu. In the first game these two teams played back in January.
Backdoor Lucas blocked by Aldridge.
Michigan State goes on a 19-3 run to put the game away in the first half.
And the jump shot on the baseline, good for Tyshawn Taylor. And Kansas goes up 42-39.
So understanding how explosive Michigan State can be, Kansas has to be really focused to stop that run.
Walton wants the ball. Collins denies him. Now Walton breaks to it. 13 to shoot. They're looking for Lucas. Walton to the bucket. And Morris comes up with the board. Now Collins. He's hit some timely baskets in this game. Knocked away Sutton.
Again, quick feet. Goran Sutton getting around into the passing lane. Aldridge has to be able to lock him. Get better body contact.
Jump shot, Sutton, pure. And Michigan State ties it up at 42. And look at Tom Izzo on the Spartan sideline, telling his guys to dig in. Collins. Aldridge jump shot. Big fella. Showing his range now, Lenny. I know you like that.
Got to remain versatile if you call Aldridge. And not letting it get it on the post. Show him something else.
Sutton jump hook. Short. Gets his own rebound, and that'll be a foul. 14:45 to play second half. Kansas holding on to a 2-point lead.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the Men's Basketball Championship is sponsored by Miller Lite and by Cadillac.
Are you as mad as a drink with real Coke taste and zero calories? Prove it. Upload your videos at tastethemadness.com and get mad famous. And a look at our Star Watch.
Well, Sharon Collins and Cole Aldridge have been mainstays for Kansas. Kalen Lucas yet to get on track on the offensive end. And Goran Sutton, huge development right now. Sutton, who's doing a pretty good job on Aldridge, certainly on the offensive end. He's carrying Michigan State with 18 points, but he's got three fouls. Now on the bench. And take a look at the field goal shooting. Michigan State shooting it a lot better from the field. Started the half at about 38%, 50% now for this half. And you look at the 10 steals and the points off turnovers. Michigan State has now gotten six in this half. And has really started to play the basketball the way they'd like. But with Sutton on the bench, we'll see where the points come from, particularly inside.
Collins, Walton really pressuring him now. They run the pick and roll and an offensive foul. Morris setting a screen, called for the foul. That's Marcus Morris, the younger twin.
And sometimes you blame it on a screener, but often it's on the ball handler trying to run his man off the screen. You got to wait till your screener gets set before you make your move. And that time, I think, on simultaneous, the move and the screen, hence the moving screen call.
So here comes Kalen Lucas. Marquise Gray is checked in. Spartans almost turn it over. Lucas finds it, fires. Off the heel, long rebound. Allen tracks it down. Spartans get a new shot clock. Walton on the floor with him. Green, Allen, and Lucas.
And another rebound as Michigan State tries to close that gap. We said that's their eraser.
And a travel called on the freshman Green.
They get another chance, but they blow it.
So here come the Spartans. Morningstar will inbound it. Collins, Tyrell Reed. They move Collins off the ball. Also Little and Morris. Collins looking for his offense and he's fouled. Good call. As Travis Walton almost had a little piece of his jersey as he tried to get around the screen.
Well, Collins did a nice job of taking his man down towards the paint, faking one way off the screen and coming off the other screen on the other side. And Walton did not want to get lost, so he had to hold on.
Collins and Walton, what a great matchup. Ball kicked by Travis Walton. Travis Walton, the defensive player of the year, three-time all-defensive team, three-time captain of the Michigan State Spartans.
And you just saw Travis Walton ask the official, watch out for the elbow. Ron Collins doing everything he can to kind of get free from the Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year.
Sharon to Little, mid-range jump shot off the heel. Walton with a rebound, outlet to his running partner, Lucas.
And I tell you what, with Goran Sutton on the bench for Michigan State with three fouls, Bill Self finds an opportunity to give Cole Aldrich a little bit of rest, knowing down the stretch he's going to need the big fella.
Let's see if they can find Allen. Athletically, he's gifted and may be able to take Morningstar off the dribble. Green, tough shot, no. And Morris with the rebound. Collins ahead of the field. Straight to the bucket. Finger roll. Got it. Unstoppable. Getting to the basket. A younger version of Tim Hardaway. Gray. And he traveled. Good call. But watch Sharon Collins. So strong.
Well, you got to feel sorry for the defender back there backpedaling with Collins with the strength and the quickness bearing down on you. And he just takes everybody to the hole.
He broke the Chicago public school record with 250 yards receiving in one game against Carver as a sophomore. Inside, Aldridge up and in.
Aldridge with fresh legs right now, ready to do some damage. And once again, the only guy that's presented a real challenge to him, Goran Sutton from Michigan State, on the bench with three fouls.
48-42. Allen fires a jump shot. Michigan State now settling. As Cole Aldrich, take a look at in the second round and this evening.
Well, another double-double, and it's been spectacular for the last three games. You can't have any complaints about the job that Cole Aldrich has done. And he certainly has to thank his teammates. And you see Goran Sutton back in the ballgame. Tom Izzo cannot wait any longer He needs to continue to contain Aldridge for Michigan State. Wants to climb back in the lead.
Aldridge goes up high, spins, kicks, steal. Lucas slicing to the bucket up short. Summers with a rebound and he's fouled.
Now what puzzles me, Gus, is three fouls on Sutton. Aldridge puts it on the floor. You got to go after the guy in foul trouble.
48-42, back after this. All right, let's take a look at the summary by half.
Well, for Kansas offensively, it's been pretty much steady as she goes, except for the turnovers, six turnovers in a half, which allowed Michigan State to climb close. But Michigan State, after starting 5 of 10 from the field in the second half, has cooled off considerably, 0 for their last 5, and that's hurting them.
Spartans with the basketball. Allen inbounding. Lucas fires. High arcer rattles home.
I think he heard me, huh?
Yeah, he did hear you. Kalen Lucas with 8 points. He averaged 16 points in conference play, 15 overall. 4-point game. Collins. Now Taylor driving. Tough shot. Taken away. Little out of bounds. We'll head the other way.
Well, Tom Izzo pretty good at diagramming plays out of a timeout. And just an easy double screen curl. It gets Kalen Lucas an open look. It's so important to be able to diagram something your guys can execute coming out of a break, particularly in close game situations. It just gives them confidence going into the remainder of that period.
Sutton kicks it out. Allen leans in. Oh, wow. He drew that foul. That's a pro move right there, Len.
Yeah, it's a pro move, but I'm not sure that's necessarily a foul on the defender. You know, you can't break that plane of verticality if Tyrell Reed is standing there, arms straight up. And Chris Allen breaks that plane and creates the contact. That foul is on him.
And it should have been a foul on him, but he gets away with it. Sunday on CBS, The Amazing Race takes you to Thailand for an hour of heart racing excitement. Don't miss a minute. Sunday on CBS, America's most watched network. Ebach ready to check back in. Chris Allen with 4 points. He averages 9 points a game, usually the first man off the bench. Rowe will take a seat. Both free throws good. 2-point ball game. 11 minutes to play. Ebach thought it was their ball.
And you know what?
We've got a close one here in Naptown. 48-46. Kansas on top of Michigan State in the rematch. Spartans won the first meeting earlier this year. Kansas has led by as many as 13. Morningstar breaks down, fires, loose ball, rebounded by Morris, and a foul.
Well, in this game, uncharacteristically, Kansas winning the battle of boards, winning the battle in the paint, as Michigan State continues to try to play catch-up. Unfortunately for Michigan State, getting very little, if anything, from their top frontline player, Raymar Morgan. But it's been Goran Sutton who's really carried the day for his team.
Sutton with 18 points. The winner of this game will take on Louisville in the regional final for a trip to the Final Four.
Louisville with a dominating performance against 12 seed Arizona. I mean, made no mistake about who should be the overall number one seed with that performance.
Now, these two teams met earlier this season, January 10th. Michigan State defeating Kansas 75-62 in East Lansing. Spartans led 37-18 at halftime. Kalen Lucas had 22 points in the first half. Jerron Collins, 25 points, but 5 points and 6 turnovers in the first half. Michigan State out-rebounded the Jayhawks. Totally different story tonight. Kansas has been all business.
And in that game, it took a 19-3 run in the first half for Michigan State to create some separation. They've tried to get out here and get explosive in this game, but Kansas has had an answer.
And Aldridge taking Ebok to the basket. Edong Ebok picking up his second.
And Ebok had some pretty good success against Aldridge in that first game. But here, Aldridge in a nice little pump fake up and under draws the foul. Cole Aldridge, probably a different player than he was early in January.
And very interesting. Tonight on The Late Show, Dave's got Joe Torre plus the day in the life of President Obama. Then on The Late Show, Late Show, Craig welcomes Lauren Graham. Don't miss Dave and Craig tonight on CBS. Very interesting note here. Since that MSU loss, Kansas went on to win 8 straight, 13 of 14. So they really started to improve and coming to their own after losing to the Spartans.
Well, sometimes it's a learning experience. And when I talk about Aldridge, probably a different player. Maybe not, but his teammates certainly think so. I mean, the performance we've seen over the last 2.5 games has been outstanding.
And that's Lucas for 3 to tie it up at 49. Kalen Lucas with 11 points. Morningstar guarded by Walton. Collins, pick and roll, turns the corner. Morningstar to the basket, and he almost turned it over. Under 10 to play. Our game is tied at 49. We've had 2 ties, 4 lead changes. Kansas is led by as many as 13 points, and they're playing for a trip to face Rick Pitino and the Louisville Cardinals.
And Michigan State, even though they're so far being out-rebounded, being manhandled in the paint, still finding a way to tie this ball game.
Collins, high arc or no. Lucas with the rebound. Spartans can take the lead right here.
It's been better defense in the middle in the second half, capitalizing on Kansas turnovers.
Walton drives, kicks, Sutton! Morris the rebound. And here comes Collins. Morris, 20-footer. 9 minutes to play, 49-49. Pick and roll, Walton, slashing, the runner, got it. And that's Michigan State's first lead since the score was 16-15. 8:41 to play, second half. Spartans up 51-49. Welcome back. Here in the Midwest, the winner of this game will take on Louisville, who defeated Arizona. Connecticut and Missouri to play tomorrow. Travis Walton had 18 points in the second round against USC, only 2 tonight. But that was a big bucket that he just hit in motion.
And with senior urgency in full effect right now, Travis Walton doesn't want to go home. And he has hit some big shots. You mentioned in the USC game, had 11 points against Kansas in their first meeting. You know, he may be just heating up, recognizing that this may be the last chance.
They go inside to Aldridge and throw it out of bounds. Looks like that was a foul. Aldridge was pushed in the back by Sutton, and that is turnover number 16 for Kansas.
But foul or no foul, you can't expect those kinds of calls. Cole Aldridge, big strong fella in the middle. You got to hold your position. Make the officials call it.
Lucas brings it into the front court. Pick and roll. Baseline, Walton again. Tapped around. Tracked down. Here come the Jayhawks. Reed. Collins is on the bench for Kansas, so somebody has to step up offensively. Inside, Morris. Great position. Turnaround jumper. And the rebound to Sutton. Lucas. Morris claims it. No call coming up the floor. Reed.
But that would have been Sutton's 4th foul. It would have given Tom Izzo a dilemma. But nevertheless, as you mentioned, no call, no advantage.
Tom Izzo yelling at his team to slow down. Collins getting ready to check back in for Kansas.
Right now, if you're Kansas and Collins still not in the ball game, you got to be extraordinarily focused on where you're going to get the ball and where your shots are coming from, and that's not the place.
Lucas in transition. Summer steps into a J. Oh, in and out. Aldridge with another great rebound. Outlet Taylor. Open court. Here comes a kid from Jersey. Up, no, but a foul. And he will go to the line. 6:54 to play. 51-49. Spartans.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the men's basketball championship is sponsored by Coke Zero, State Farm, Burger King, and by Chevy.
When you take a look at the first half, second half output by Kansas two stars in direct correlation to the change in the lead. When Aldridge and Collins were flowing in the first half, Kansas' largest lead was by 13. In the second half, they've been slowed down, and they're down by two.
Sharon Collins getting ready to come back into the game for the Jayhawks. Meanwhile, Tyshawn Taylor is at the free throw line. He's a 71% free throw shooter. First free throw good for Tyshawn Taylor. 51-50, Michigan State with the lead. Kansas is led by as many as 13, the Spartans by as many as two. And right now we are tied up at 51 as one of the best players in the nation comes back into the game. Sharon Collins, the leader of this Jayhawk team at the point guard spot. Now they let Chris Allen bring the ball up the floor. Travis Walton, Sutton, Green, and Summers. Allen to the basket. The runner got it.
The beneficiary of a double screen allowed him to curl and get into the paint.
He has 7 points. A tremendous athlete. I mean, Chris Allen can really sky and dunk the ball. Pick and roll, Morningstar. Looks baseline, Morris. Aldridge, and he banks it in. Cole Aldridge eating up rebounds, 17 points and 11 rebounds. And we're tied at 53, approaching the 6 minute mark. The winner to advance to take on Louisville for a trip to the Final Four. Allen, 20 footer. Aldridge knocks it away. Picked up Collins. Morningstar driving and he traveled.
And that's the biggest problem Kansas has had this whole evening. Early on, support guys like Brady Morningstar, Tyrell Reed were looking at the basket, becoming threats. Now that we're getting in crunch time, these guys are not willing to look at it and become threats, not willing to take their time, too busy trying to give the ball up, and they're making mistakes that Michigan State looks to capitalize upon.
So Kalen Lucas is back in the game. He has the ball now. He's a Big Ten Player of the Year. Travis Walton, Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year. Guarded by Reed. Green, the freshman. And Walton to reshuffle.
Good judgment right there. Bogged down offense, reset.
Walton peels it back, 5 to shoot. He's got to hurry now. 3 to shoot. Walton. And he doesn't get it off. Great defense by Kansas.
The only problem is when you reset, you got to have some purpose. Got to have some way to get back into your offensive set. And that time, even though Walton backed it out, it was time to run another play. Michigan State stagnant.
Ebach checks back in. Green heads to the bench. Ebach in for defensive purposes to guard Cole Aldridge. 13 turnovers for Michigan State. And here comes Sharon Collins, the hard-nosed point guard from Chicago. He's got all the shots. Collins, baseline, Reed.
That's what I'm talking about. Look at the basket, be a threat. Take the pressure off of your teammates. Wide open look, knock it down.
56-53. Kansas. And that was the first basket of the game for Reed. Timeout, Michigan State. 4:40 to play, second half. We've got a three-point game here in Naptown. Monday on CBS, there's a new girl next door, and the Big Bang Boys couldn't be happier. Catch a new Big Bang Theory Monday on CBS, America's most watched network. 4:40 to play as we take a look at the game reset.
Michigan State with three timeouts, but they're already in the penalty. Kansas in good defensive position. They've got a couple fouls to give.
Kaylin Lucas, guarded by Collins, really squatting down now defensively. Sutton wide open. Loose ball. Aldridge with the rebound.
And you saw how he made sure, didn't keep the ball down, raised it above so no one could get to it.
Aldridge with 13 rebounds to go along with his 17 points.
And here's where the little things really count.
Collins takes it away to the bucket. Oh my goodness, what a finger roll. And he comes up limping. 58-53. Jerron Collins with 18. Allen, Sutton, great position. Nice pass by Chris Allen. Sutton with 20. And a couple of players limping now. Marcus Morris is limping. Jerron Collins is limping.
Jerron Collins may be momentary, because when he gets back into the flow of the game, he makes it happen, finger roll and all.
Look at his strength. You can tell he played a little football then.
LeBron James.
Are you going to do anything with this?
Oh, me?
Wait until you see what he does on 60 Minutes. Sunday.
As we take a look at the game reset, Michigan State with three timeouts, Kansas with two. Spartans are over the limit, and the Jayhawks have some fouls to give. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore with you, 58-55. Indianapolis, Indiana, downtown, Kansas up. Over the Spartans, the winner to take on Louisville for a trip to the Final Four on Sunday. Kansas, the defending national champion.
I'm just taking a look at Jerron Collins. Came off limping, but he's bouncing up and down right now. May not be any worse for the wear. And once you get into game time situation, you forget all that.
Tyrone Reed brings the ball up the floor with Kaylin Lucas, and he almost swiped it. Lucas with some very quick hands. He has a couple of steals in this game. And he's stolen the ball quite often by letting the offensive player go by him and poking it away from behind.
And that matchup made Bill Self very nervous. So now they run a play to get the ball back into Collins' hands. They wanted to use him and get him involved in the offense. But now he's got to run the show.
14 to shoot for Collins. He'll take his time. Trying to break down the defense now. Collins driving, fades, and buries it. What a player. Jerron Collins has put on a show in this tournament. 60-55.
You talked about it. You said he had will. And then some.
Backdoor Summers. Green is there. Sutton. Oh, and it's finally knocked back down.
And that's Michigan State basketball once again. Led the nation in rebound margin. You know, so tenacious on the offensive glass.
But can they stop this man, Jerron Collins?
And look at the battle down low. Sutton and Aldridge trying to get position. They kind of backed off each other when the ball was on that side.
Collins, six to shoot, crossover, baseline, Morningstar. He's got to pull the trigger. And Sutton has the board. Here comes Lucas. In and out to the basket. No. Out of bounds and a foul. A foul coming up. And it's going to go against Kansas.
But Kansas, that's only their fifth team foul, so they can afford to be more aggressive. Take a look right there. There's the push. It looks like Reed. But Michigan State has inbound the ball. They don't get to the free throw line.
Walton, the inbounder. Foul called on Reed is fourth.
And Kansas actually has one more foul to give.
Summers, the inbounder now to Lucas. 60-57. Summers shows it. Give and go to the bucket up. No, but a foul. And Darrell Summers will go to the line and shoot two.
And you got to admire the perseverance. You know, State could have pulled it out. Didn't have to go with that particular play. And Summers going to the basket strong, draws the foul.
First one good, the winner of this game moves on to the Elite Eight to take on the Louisville Cardinals, the number one overall seed in this tournament, for a trip to the Final Four in the Motor City. Summers missed the second, long rebound, and the Spartans have it with a chance to tie it with a deuce. And Tom Izzo calls a timeout. 2 minutes to play. Kansas 60, Michigan State 58. All right, the game reset. Each team with two timeouts, neither team with a foul to give. And the ladies that stand next to the men, Lupe, Izzo, Cindy Self. And you, a picture is worth a thousand words. Now, coming out of timeouts, Coach Izzo has been very good.
Yeah, actually, the last two times Michigan State has had the ball out of timeouts, he's run people off of a double screen, gets his shooters there. But Goran Sutton this time kind of mixes up Kansas a little bit.
Lucas, stop and start inside! And that's a jam! Raymar Morgan finally pounded it down.
Well, he said he had to get a mean streak. This is as good a time as any on the penetration.
And we're tied at 60. 1:35 to go. Collins. And a timeout, Kansas. What a game developing. 1:31 to play. We're knotted up at 60. Spartans attacking. Kansas with one timeout remaining. Michigan State with two. Gus Johnson, Len Elmore with you. So, Lenny, a minute and 31 to go. What do you see?
Well, first of all, the sands have shifted. Kansas with the advantage not too long ago with three times out and two fouls away from going into the penalty. Now they're pretty even on the foul situation. Only one timeout, so Kansas has to recognize, you know, that situation as well as the idea that they've got to get something in the paint.
12 to shoot inside. Collins throws it away.
Trying to draw fouls, get it in the paint. But right there, maybe Collins gave it up when he shouldn't have.
18 turnovers for the Jayhawks. So here come the Spartans, Lucas and Walton. And Tom Izzo calls a timeout. 1:07 to play in regulation. We're tied at 60. Each team with a timeout remaining. Michigan State with the basketball right now. What's Tom Izzo thinking, in your opinion, coming out of this timeout?
Well, that high double screen has been good to Michigan State, getting shooters curling off it a couple of times in a row, then having Goran Sutton pop. They may wind up setting it again, but watch for somebody to slip the screen and try to go to the basket.
It's been Sutton in the past. Allen inbounds. Morgan. Here comes Lucas.
There's a single screen on the fade.
Summers, 18 to shoot. Now they'll run their offense. Under a minute to go. Lucas breaking to the ball. 10 to shoot. Guarded by Collins. They spread the floor. Here comes a Big Ten player of the year. Spinning in traffic. Leaning up. Counted on the foul. Kalen Lucas. Big time player. And he'll go to the line.
Well, when all else doesn't work, shot clock running down. 5 seconds left. Lucas breaks down the defense, gets Collins off his feet. Just a little hesitation, Collins trying to anticipate. But that's what a classic point guard does. Push it up the floor, try to explore the defense. You run your stuff if you don't have numbers, but when the shot clock runs down, you got to break them down, create for yourself or others.
And he adds a free throw. 8-0 run for Michigan State. So Bill Self on the sideline, you can hear him yelling, five up. That's the play. Morningstar, the inbounder. Collins will bring it up the floor. Don't expect him to give it up.
Well, we saw what Kalen Lucas did on that end. You got a luxury with Sharon Collins, capable of the same.
They run two guys at him. Reed driving. And a whistle. Bill Self and the Jayhawks will call their final timeout. 63-60. 34 seconds remaining for a trip to the Elite Eight. Kansas out of timeouts. Michigan State with one. Possession arrow favors the Jayhawks. And Kansas with the basketball. Both teams over the limit, shooting 1-1.
Well, first of all, if you're Michigan State, you don't want to foul. 13-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. You have another chance in the event that Kansas can knock down a three. But to keep them from knocking down threes, play on top of screens, force them to go back inside. And if you're Kansas, you get an opportunity for a quick two. You can possibly foul. Whoa, what is that?
That looked like a foul there.
That's definitely
a trip. And it is a foul. That is a foul. He was tripped. Taylor tripped. And that's an excellent call.
Good call by the official. It created, certainly created an advantage. It wasn't done. He tripped over his own feet. It wasn't even a trip by Kalen Lucas.
Or did he trip over Cole Aldridge's feet?
You know, it looked like he got his own feet tangled up.
Wow.
Officials couldn't see it, but it looked like he got his own feet tangled up.
So how about this? Tyshawn Taylor, a freshman at the line. Two big ones here. Shooting 1-1, he gets the front end. Take another look, folks.
Right there. Trips over his own feet.
So the Jayhawks catch a break. One more free throw.
Well, actually, it may not be a break. You only got two shots right here. Michigan State has the ball. May wind up forcing Kansas to foul. They're going to pressure and look to try to steal.
In the backcourt, and a foul coming up as Lucas draws contact. With 26 seconds to play.
That's the best course of action for Kansas. Michigan State had the opportunity to run the clock out since the shot clock was off, so you got to extend the game. Remember I talked about the little things?
Yeah.
Here's where blocking out on the free throw line. How often have we seen that? With an opportunity in the event of a miss and you don't block out, and the leading team gets possession.
63-62, Michigan State at 2, trying to knock off the defending national champions. Lucas 1-1. 64-62. Kalen Lucas, 15 points. 3 of 3 from the free throw line. And he gets a second. Still, one possession game.
We got to push it up. Depending on the timing, you can go for a quick two.
Here's Collins, and a foul.
Well, he might. Tom Izzo upset with that.
And a foul, which stops the clock at 19 seconds.
But it looked as though, again, Kansas playing for the three as Collins gets the ball above the three-point line. Getting a screen.
It was Walton called for the foul.
Remember, Collins only gets two. Kansas still has the lead if he makes it.
And he missed it. He missed a free throw. Lucas, keep away, fouled in the backcourt, and Michigan State will shoot.
See, even if Collins had made both, Michigan State still with a one-point lead, you'd force Kansas to come back and foul you again. So that may not have been such a bad thing as Tommy got upset. Tom Izzo got upset, but who knows? obviously worked to his benefit, and now the miss certainly works to the benefit of Michigan State. They just got to knock one down and make it a two-possession ball game.
So going to the free throw line for the Spartans will be Lucas, and look how calm Lupe Izzo is. On the outside, she is calm, but on the inside, she must be churning. Lucas trying to make this a two-possession game. And the first one goes down. The defending national champs on the ropes now. A lot of time left, 14.4.
And I expect Michigan State to provide some token pressure just to keep Kansas from getting a running start. But if I'm Kansas, I try to push the ball up quickly. You got to look for a quick two, depending on the amount of time it takes to get up the floor.
Lucas, 7 of 7 from the line. Morningstar, the inbounder.
The reason you look for a quick two is because Michigan State doesn't want to foul you.
Here comes Taylor. Collins turns the corner. They're wasting a lot of time. Takes a three. Inside, no. Knocked out of bounds with 3.2 to go. The Michigan State Spartans are 3 seconds away.
See, I would have gone for the quick two. Michigan State wouldn't have fouled, and then you get the ball in bounds and foul.
Inside, knocked away by Sutton, and that's it. The Spartans were down by 13. They come back and knock off the defending national champions, 67-62. Up next, Rick Pitino and the Louisville Cardinals. And how about that for Michigan State? Lupe Izzo, huge hug for her family as her husband's team advances our Chevrolet player of the game. Sharon Collins and Kaylin Lucas. Lucas 18-7, 7 of 7 from the free throw line. Down the stretch, Michigan State closed on a 12-2 run. So it's all set. Louisville, Michigan State, Connecticut, and Missouri for a trip to the Final Four in the Motor. For Len Elmore, this is Gus Johnson saying so long from Naptown. Let's go to Greg Gumbel in New York.
All right, Gus, one more Sunday slot still to be determined. That